Colin. Miss this one.
We are arriving at the main terminal building. Proceed to the first floor for baggage claim and ground transportation. For connecting flights, proceed to the second level. This is the only stop. Estamos llegando al edificio principal de la terminal. Diríjase al primer piso.
Thank you.
long time ago.
Love that.
Much water to fill the Amazon as it does any other river. A lot of it due largely to the waterfalls like these over here. Now these are inspiration falls. And you know, every time we get to this point, the crews, I'm always asked by my crew, together in unison, why do you call them inspiration falls? I'm glad you asked. We call them inspiration falls because they usually inspire sensible people like us to go deeper and deeper into the jungle. Now it's going to be a small party. Oh wow, and it's kind of a dead party. Something must have scared them off because they were here just a little while ago. Anybody see anything that could have scared them off? Anything at all? Oh, this is a giant python. You know, he grew up to 24 feet long, but don't worry, he's quite friendly. He has to pick up a few things, and oh wow, would you look at that? I've got some uninvited house guests. That's what happens when you leave your front door unlocked in the jungle. And you know, I tried all the Congo River. We're going to join the Nile River. The Nile River is over 4,000 miles long, and it goes on for Nile and Nile and Nile. Yeah, this guy right here, well, he's an African elephant. We know he's an African elephant by his large floppy ears. He can hear up to 2 miles away. Louder. Now, squirt! Oh, look at everybody in the back, Doc. We haven't followed, like these zebras, wildebeest, and giraffes. They come here to the African belt to get water from the Nile. But they don't always make it back into herd. The lions on the rocks take care of that. That's an example of a first law of the jungle, survival of the fittest. And well, folks, if that was an example of the first law, here's an example of the second law, survival of the fastest. Yes, even though a rhino weighs 2.5 tons, he can still run as fast as a horse. I tried to tell those guys earlier, but I guess the guy at the bottom is going to get the point. You need a pool? So you got to show them you're friendly by wiggling your ears. It's just well of you to wiggle your ears because it's going to take the boat clean apart. Look out for this guy over here. Oh, and there's another one over here. Look out, look out. Folks, we're in native country. Now, this is the wrong place to be headed. Now, usually the natives are pretty friendly. But if they do attack, they attack on the right side. So everybody keep an eye out on the right side. Looking pretty clear. You guys see anything up on the right? Looking pretty good. Well, folks, here's a sight you don't get to see very often. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Here it is. Right here is the backside of water. Kind of looks like a front.
Sit down.
You're doing it.
Not happening.
Yeah.
know that.
It was a mini
Yeah, it was, but it's closed, isn't it?
There's Space Mountain!
Thank you.
Thank you. is he?
All agree that the first thing you notice about the VAB is that it's big.
In fact, we're looking at one of the largest buildings in the world. Let me give you an idea how big this building is. You see the stripes on the flag up there that we painted to celebrate this nation's bicentennial? Well, we could drive this bus down one of those stripes.
You've got 3 million pounds of shuttle sitting on top of 9 million pounds of launch platform. So how are you going to move 12 million pounds?
In the support system, we have two complete backup systems. And if one little thing is wrong with either backup system, that orbiter is not going to leave this building.
Al, of all the thousands of tasks you perform on an orbiter, what's the most time-consuming?
Probably inspecting and repairing thermal tiles that cover the orbiter. There are more than 20,000 of them. We have to make sure every micro-inch is perfect. That's because the tiles act as the orbiter's skin, protecting it from the cold of space, which can reach 250 degrees below zero in the shade, to the tremendous heat of re-entry. When you're coming back in Earth's atmosphere, Sally, and hitting 25...
Now, if you remember, a while back, Al asked a question. How do you move 12 million pounds of shuttle and platform to the launch pad? If you look over to your right, you'll see the answer. The crawler transporter is the biggest track to get...
Each of the steel plates weighs 2,000 pounds. Now, the crawler transporter moves slowly into the vertical assembly building, picks up the 9 million pound mobile launch platform that you see to our distant right.
The vehicle assembly building is the launch control center. The launch control center is the electronic brain of Launch Complex 39. It's the home base of a complicated computer system that oversees the entire checkout and launch process of the space shuttle.
Of the shuttle. Out to our distant right in the better view, Complex 40 and 41, the tape canal.
Approaching the LC-39 observation gantry, the 54-foot tower to your right is located less than 6,500 feet from...
As the interior propellant tanks fill, some of the propellant turns to gas.
Package that cannot be retrieved. It serves as a large fuel tank with the orbiter's three main engines. About 8 minutes after that, there's a large pool of water here. A lot of times we get manatees and gators on the dirt. Pretty good size, too.
and touch the moon.
We've been up there for 5 months.
Station hardware and technical systems are shipped here from all over the world. It's our job to perform the detailed tests and inspections that verify each part will function properly in space. Tastes more like a grapefruit, but it's sweeter and larger. And less space.
Also, by growing them vertically, you get better airflow through the leaves, which reduces disease, and gravity will pull down the cucumbers to make them larger. We also release predator insects like wasps and ladybugs, cycle those plants, and delivers important information 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So last screen out, so our creative, we're studying Eridos, which have been genetically engineered to produce a gene which we're still working with scientists from NASA. We use recycled water and oxygen from waste products to grow plants in space colonies.
You'll be happy with the foods you eat. Mixing different kinds, each meal can be a treat.
Salad overnight. style the classic Chevy Cheddar with exercise.
Come on, baby, let's exercise.
Just don't get it, do you?
Listen, we'll tell you what's real.
Yeah!
Jump! We're tired of this nutrition stuff. We're tired of hearing bark.
We're tired of hearing about exercise.
Cause you know there's nothing like staying at home.
Lying on the couch.
Watching the tube.
With a great big bowl of fat and steaming junk.
Jeremy did.
Oh, it's right down there.
Cool. another one there.
Look at that fish.
It looks like there's a fly.
Scuba diver.
Just watch. away. What do you think? Do you think of anything you can tell everybody out there what her skin feels like? Like a tire, yes, like a rubber beach ball, very, very firm. Well done, down the hatch. We're off to a great start. I think Shamu is really enjoying Lori's company. Yes. Now, Ryan, I'm wondering, can you beat this?
Well, I think we can. Thanks.
Thank you. Remember this? Ladies and gentlemen, this is the splash warning which you saw before the show started today. Now, you're about to meet the next member of our Shamu family. It also happens to be the largest killer whale in any marine life park in the entire world. Now, folks, just to put its size into perspective for all of you out there, the whale which you just saw weighs around 5,000 pounds. Well, this next whale weighs over 12,000 pounds. And folks, he is over 23 feet in length. So what does this mean to all of you out there? Well, he can splash twice as much of this ice cold 52 degrees salt water right into all of your laps. You know, I don't see a lot of people moving, so let me make myself a little more clear, because I'm not just talking about all of those people in the lower singing section.
onde iremos voltar a funcionar. Uma vez mais, pedimos desculpas pelo transtorno, mas em decorrência a problemas técnicos,
I'm going to go to the next one.
Okay, where are you from?
From home.
Okay. Hi, what's your name? Scott, nice to meet you. Where are you from, Scott?
From Georgia. Well, how would I say well, welcome for Georgia?
Scott, I see you going to the Busch Gardens from your shirt there. That's our sister park in Tampa. Did you have a good time?
Yeah.
Did you like all the animals down there?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, look, we've got, look at this. This is Dolly Dolphin right here. How'd you like to meet her? Okay, why don't we meet her like when you meet somebody else? Walk right up to this edge. That's right, that's 24-foot drop-off. Okay, right out there, and a nice handshake, just like that. Reach down and grab our slipper.
Thank you.
your safety.
This about spoils your lunch, doesn't it?
Four times that.
school, yeah?
Yeah, not too much.
Because I have to
be on that side of here, doing your job.
Oh my God. What is that? I don't know. Need a flashlight.
It's not that big a tank, is it? If you don't. Well, it's like blinkers.
He's coming right here, right there.
Where?
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 Please face forward and step up.
Please face forward and step up. The laid out back. Very nice. Who's gonna get on the board first? Whoa! Good to say, point three. Old West. These athletes here with quick thrills. And over 40 miles an hour. about
hold it, yes. Yes, it's like tour wrap. It could be a double helicopter with a split. Yes, it's going to be two.
Georgia.
Barbara Flynn, where are you?
Well, what's going on? Come on, Mom.
Look, kid, dear.
Oh, dear.
No need to worry.
We'll keep it simple.
friends, your dinner.
Thank you. It's a lucky 13-story tall that stops off with that large set of Mickey Mouse ears. Seen on Animal Planet, called Pittsburgh, USA, films here as well. Now, even though it seems like we're pretty busy out here for a casting crew, it's pretty much all the day's work here at the Disney MGM Studios. Here on the right, we have a great photo opportunity. That's the armadillo. You might recognize that from the summer smash hit film Armageddon, starring Bruce Willis. Number 242, that brown western-styled house was used in the film Ernest Saves Christmas, starring Jim Varney. That was the very first full-length feature filmed entirely here at the Disney MGM Studios. When production crews travel to different towns, they often encounter stuff they can't control, such as crowds, traffic, and noise. That's why they prefer to shoot out here one of our backlot sets. They can control all of that, including the weather. Coming up is a very popular house, so get your cameras ready. Over on the left side of your shuttle, you'll see it. For Seven Seasons, the Space Hawaiian-styled house can be seen as from the Disney Channel's Adventures in Wonderland. And if you're familiar with the Golden Girls, you know they had famous TV neighbors, the Westons, when they actually lived across the street to our right. That two-story facade was once the home to the hit sitcom Empty Nest, starring Richie Mulligan, Donna Manoff, Marsha Warfield, and Bear the Dog as Dreyfus. Hi, up ahead of us is the Irving counterparts Residential Street. There are New York City streets that we're going to come back a little later on in our tour, though. Right now, they're on the corner to say hi to everybody in the back half of the show. Remember, thank you, folks. We also have a miniature truck here. This was used in transporting a puppet-sized Mighty Joe Young from the film that we just released on video. And we have a couple of military-looking vehicles here. We have the convertible truck and large tank that are from Steven Spielberg's Indiana Jones in The Last Crusade, starring Sean Connery and Harrison Ford. The tread on that tank is really styrofoam rubber. That's for the safety of our stunt actors. Those two mining carts are from the Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom film. They were used in a big chase scene. Here we have a large menacing monster from Who Framed Roger Rabbit. That's Judge Doom's Toontown Dipmobile, used to put an end to all those cartoon characters. But of course we know Jessica and Roger, well, they lived happily ever after. These three blue Plymouths are from that hit film as well, but they were used to represent just one car in that film. There are really seven, but they only had three that were presentable. Here's the yellow helicopter from the Universe of Energy attraction over at Epcot Center, starring Bill Nye the Science Guy and Ellen DeGeneres. The blue helicopter cockpits from Blue Thunder and the GB stunt plane and Hughes aircraft are from the Rock Theater. If you look across the town to the right, you get a great backstage view of Residential Street. Not a whole lot of privacy here in this neighborhood. As you can see, all of the architecture that does get very, definitely tell you about what goes on in here, that's for sure. Now, our canyon is based after a real Southern California canyon. I think our designer's about to go over. Scene one, take two, wait a minute. This is Logan, everyone please remain seated, stay calm, looks like we're gonna be in this scene. Remain seated. This is very important. This is for your safety. Folks, once again, thank you very much. Texture, but they can all withstand hurricane force winds of about 100 miles an hour. Through the arch, you can see our New York City skyline. That's a movie effect called Forced Perspective, created by placing painted flats at the end of our streets. The streets a block and a half long, and those flats are no more than four stories tall. But on film and video, it does come out looking like a very good representation of the New York City skyline. Unfortunately, we have reached the end of our tour here. We're letting you off, though, to our American Film Institute Showcase, where you can see puppets, miniatures, and models.
Yeah, fabulous job. You go wild and crazy guy. And our last guy?
Kevin.
All right, Kevin. I need an evil, menacing, sinister this guy that has his great ensemble on. Hi, what's your name?
Tyler.
Tyler, all right, Tyler. Come right over here. I need you to do me a pose like this. Here you go. There you go. Kind of show off that shirt there. That's good. That's good, Tyler. You know, my leg was a little higher. There you go. Over there. You're doing good. Just you work on that. I'm going to come check on you in a minute, all right? There you go. Then hold it. There you go. Go ahead. Yeah, there you go. Mouth wide open. There you go. Freeze. Don't move. Ladies, I love it. Stay just like that. Tyler, you're doing a good job. Did you know your leg was a little higher earlier? Yeah. There you go. Hold it nice and steady. Are you ready for this? Wait till I'm done. Here you go. No, you saw what I did. Go ahead and strut your stuff. Yeah, there you go, Joe. There you go. Woo! Strut your pose. Hold it out there. There you go.
Thank you. so much on Russell and the crew. None of this would be possible without them. It's teamwork, and, well, that's really what it's all about.
Yeah, we got a great crew out here, boss. Give me a round of applause back to me that makes this all happen at anniversary. All right, let's try another one. Are you terrified? Well, be terrified. Okay. You're not really very hot, sir. You're leaning to your left. No, that is your left. Oh, they're quick on the uptake tonight. Been here a long time, sir. What's your name, sir?
Brian.
Brian? You're my volunteer. Step out here, Brian. All it takes is to go the wrong direction, Brian, and I grab you. Now, Brian, this is a big scene. Are you pumped?
Yeah!
That's good. It's called Brian's Death Scene. Death Scene. Yeah, you're ready? Good. Now, I'm going to shoot you, Brian, and you're going to give me a painful, agonizing, Academy Award-winning death. You can do that, can't you, Brian? That's good. Okay. Yes. The word is yes. You got all this territory out here, Brian, to really ham it up. But Brian, that's real concrete down there, so die gently. Yes, that's expensive to replace. Extras, I need you to support Brian. A lot of screaming and shouting and comporting and everything Anna told you to do. Brian, you ready, man?
Yeah.
All right, go stand up there with me, please, sir. Turn around, face me. All right, good. Come back a little bit, Brian. All right, there you go, good. Now, Brian, I am going to say action, and I want you to come towards me. And I want you to run. It's kind of slick out here. And I want you to fall and hurt yourself. We want to kill you. You ready, Brian? All right, and action. Work it, Brian! Work it. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's good, Brian. Yeah. I'm not dead, Brian. Now you're dead. Good, great. Good job, Brian.
Rolling.
Speak.
Column 16124, Apple Cairo encounter, take one, Mark.
Playback! Background action!
powerful than the imagination. For in a moment...
Thank you. what's going on? Uh-oh.
Thank you. You'll love this one more thing.
Thank you. It's a Komodo dragon.
They play any song, joking, speak color.
The a relative of the horse and the rhinoceros. It has a very similar face shape to the rhino.
So now, Labor Day is on it. I see it in my time.
There's no window.
The big one on the right hand side is called the giant flying fox. We have about 90 giant flying foxes in here. They cannot fall down. Only one is good enough. And this bag has a size half of them on the table. They eat only fruit. And they are endangered now because of the human. The big
thank you.
Without having legs or not. And to the right hand side, you can see the Serengeti grassland system. This is where the wilder basin zebras migrate to. Termite mounds are made when termite saliva is mixed up with mud. Only one young one, and the right one is 15 years. Sexual maturity for the female is 4 years. When the those ones look like babies, but they are not babies. They are very, very mature terms. These ones are the Patterson Eland. Also, you can see the giraffe to the right hand side. And this baboon to the left. But on a very, very rare occasion, this one is 1,500 pounds. So the female can be up to 1,700 pounds. These ones are the reticulated, which means a neck. And one half comes from an Arabic word, which means one is the best one. As you notice, the color of that one, which is in front, is totally different from the others. This is because it's much older than the others. They can run up to 70 miles per hour for a distance of 500 meters. Fox, if you throw any meat to the cheetah, it will not eat the meat.
Okay, Sipawa, but keep your eyes open for anything unusual.
21 and Utua, over.
Please, Sipawa, we need your help.
Okay, Fox, is everyone ready to help Wilson stop the poachers?
All right, okay.
Great.
Oh, there! It's a big
well, we missed the pants. Because they even took 2 days to
Oye, 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 oye. Mira, José, ¿tú viste? Exacto, te vi. ¡Ay! 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 ¡Ay!
This kind of fear in 4 years old, because if he tries to move that way, he will believe in the place for him. Typically now. Yeah. As of the summer, about 18 years old, he's weighing around 475 pounds.
Like this, that's human life.
Yeah!
is time.
Thank you. Like you asking me about it? Tommy, go and sit, stand beside him. Go on, stand beside him.
Look, he's doing Scooby-Doo now. And the guy can tell, like,
such a dream.
to rage, this big ball of fire. DJ, nothing was my face was flooded. Yeah.
Onto the handrails to one hour journey and stay clear of the doors. For the comfort of others, no smoking please. Thank you. We hope you've enjoyed the Magic Kingdom. Within the 47 square miles of the Walt Disney World Resort, you'll discover much more entertainment and recreation for all ages. Each themed Disney resort features daytime and nighttime activities. For a wide variety of shopping, dining, and nighttime entertainment, visit Disney Boardwalk to experience River Country, Typhoon Lagoon, and Blizzard Beach, our themed water parks. Each night here on the Seven Seas Lagoon, we present our electrical water pageant. This shimmering musical parade features King Neptune and other creatures of the deep. Located between Disney's Grand Floridian and Polynesian resorts is Disney's Wedding Pavilion. Couples may exchange vows in a fairy tale setting, complete with the picturesque backdrop of Cinderella Castle. Experience a South Sea Island adventure at Disney's Polynesian Resort. Inside the Great Ceremonial House, you can enjoy breakfast with Minnie Mouse or a unique dining experience at Ohana.
Sleepy, dopey, happy, grumpy, sneezy. Anybody else for Daisy, Donald?
Sure.
I'll
be good
for a round,
Roger.
All right, folks, take the driver a few minutes to get to that side of the parking lot. Please remain seated. We'll meet each other as soon as we can. Or Cash, we've got a couple of folks here I didn't see. Maybe they'll be picked up soon as we turn around here. All right, folks, we'll make a quick stop here, grab a couple guests, and we'll be on our way.
Thank you.